Now we are going to look at how permeability comes from equating the fluxes into a membrane on the feed side, through the membrane, and then out of the membrane on the permeate side. The flux is equal to the mass transfer coefficient times the concentration in the liquid on the feed side minus the concentration in the liquid still near the surface of the membrane on the feed side. That's equal to the diffusivity times the equilibrium constant divided by the thickness times the concentration at the interface. Now this is in the fluid. The dissolved phase concentration was K prime times C1i, so that has been substituted in here. So minus C2i. So again, we have assumed that the equilibrium constant is the same on both sides of the membrane, and that is then equal to KC2 times C2i minus C2. So this combination of terms out in front here in the membrane transport term, that is defined as the permeance, which we will use a double line P for. So that is the permeance of the component in the membrane. This has dimensions of length per time, or can also be written in terms of moles per area per time per pascal for a gas phase. The permeability is a similar constant. It is just the diffusivity times the equilibrium constant. So the thickness that is divided out for the permeance is multiplied back in. So the permeability is the permeance times the thickness of the membrane. That is sometimes given the symbol PM for permeability. The reason both of these terms are defined is because often the membrane thickness is not something that is known or well characterized, and so the permeance is used instead of the permeability. The diffusivity and the equilibrium constant are typically measured in separate types of experiments, or possibly just from flux measurements you can determine the permeance, which is the combined effects of the diffusivity and the equilibrium constant. Having equated all of these fluxes, we can now remove the intermediate unknown concentrations, just like is done in physics sometimes for resistance and series models. So we can say C1 minus C1i is equal to the flux divided by KC1. C1i minus C2i is the flux divided by the permeance. And C2i minus C2 is the flux divided by KC2. So if we add up these equations, the intermediate concentrations at the interface disappear, and we end up with C1 minus C2 is equal to the flux times 1 over KC1 plus 1 over the permeance plus 1 over KC2. And then rearranging, we get an equation for the flux, which is like a resistance in series equation, because this is resistances in series, that shows the overall driving force of C1 minus C2, the concentration difference of the component in the liquid on the feed side, minus that in the permeate side, divided by 1 over KC1 plus 1 over the permeance plus 1 over KC2.